Yeah, Unit 4B. That's us, Creative Juice, headquarters.
Showing the sign.
Yeah, of course.
I made it. Simple. Creative Juice. Carton, juice coming out of it. Says it all.
Yeah, the beauty about it as well is you don't even need the words, do you?
No, exactly.
That's why you did it.
That's exactly why I did it. Also,
yep.
Put it on the wrong side of the door, so people just drive past, don't even see us here.
It is a bit annoying, to be honest, because we have missed a lot of posts.
Oh, that's completely irrelevant. We don't want that. What do you need posts for?
It's just I missed a birthday card from my nan, and she usually puts like 50 quid in it. Sorry for the early start. It was just Lloyd was very excited about his new product that he's got, that he wants us to work on, basically. He's our main client, he's one of two clients, basically. So whenever he's got a new product, we're very excited to get involved. We had a phone call about it. I didn't fully understand, but sometimes with these things, it's best to just come get your hands on the product, see what you're working with, and then, you know, the creative juices just start flowing through your brain like rivers of creativity. And sometimes it's actually too much and you just got to slow down, you know, chill out, and then, you know, get back on it. But yeah, he's a bit funny about cameras and stuff, so just hold tight, just stay back a little bit, because he gets a bit can be quite violent. But
yeah, I've got a lot of trust issues now, to be honest, about yogurt. I 100% blame it for me getting fired from my last job. And the idea of me having to work on another yogurt-related project is just really, really upsetting to me.
Mate, is it? Is that it?
Yeah, this is it. This is the 100% milk yogurt, strictly for men only.
It's actually shitter than I expected it to be.
I am really concerned about the product for a number of reasons. The way it looks, that's a major problem. I can sort of see what he's doing with the gaffer tape, sort of ties in with his whole concept of it being a yogurt strictly for men. Which in itself is a bit of a problem. The spoon, that's another problem. That and also he was talking about how he only wants it sold exclusively in pubs.
Jesus, he like super glued this on or something, like. Yeah, that's what I thought was just fucking milk. Let me get a fucking towel. Jesus. He said to me, the product is 95% complete. Does that look like 95% complete?
It's definitely 100% milk.
You realise this is going to be harder to promote than Shepherd's Delight?
Yep.
Shepherd's Delight was a UK garage night / foam party that served shepherd's pies between 7 and 9 p.m. Was it a success? No. Not in the slightest. I mean, I love shepherd's pie, but do I want to eat it in a nightclub setting? No. You know, everyone says that if you build it, they will come. But in this case, we built it and no one came. So.
Yeah, that's just milk. That's 100% fucking milk.
And we don't even know yet what the product's called. And there's a couple of names floating around in my head that if he picks, we can't recover from. At all. We just gotta hope that he isn't gonna call it what I think he might call it. So, yeah.
Yeah, Lloyd, as always, we are 100% on board with this product. We're very excited, and you know what? It's gonna be a winner.
Hey, listen, Graham. We've got a name for the product.
You've settled on a name for the product?
Yeah. We got a name. After a lengthy discussion with the board, we finally settled on the name.
Yeah.
Man Milk.
So you're 100% certain you want to call your product man milk?
It's brilliant. It's milk for men. Man milk. I mean, what other name could it possibly be? I've got to go, but yeah.
All right, mate. Yeah, catch you later.
All right, laters.
That is quite unfortunate. Thing is, deep down, I always knew it would be man milk.